down there to clean up. I was running it deeper and steeper, more water, steeper, just so I can shovel more dirt through it, but I'm gonna take a lunch. Mostly there isn't as much magnetics in the this time this cleanup. She's all she get about a constant, you know, clean up in an area of magnetics. So if you're shy, maybe your map's too deep, water's too fast, you're blowing out, you're black sand, you kind of want to keep those, they help hold the gold in. You know, nice little powdery bed of black sands. Camera focus. So there's the gold from the second run. It got a little bit better in the clay there, and you can see there's more gold, more fine gold. Oops, sorry guys. And about the same amount of dirt last time. I was a little bit steeper. So that's what I missed in that second pan. Kind of see it up there in the corner. So did better on the second pan. right next to the bigger pan, but you know what, I'm doing just like that. Less water in this one makes it harder. Perhaps the mining invention of the decade, in my opinion. You know, all these people talk about this stuff. If you look at what this thing does, it is amazing. Here's a tool. If you move all the magnetic sands out of your pan, a few moments, not lose any of the gold, even if you rush it, what do you lose? A couple specs, and you can go back over them. Only eliminating that delta of all that fine gold has to shift through that black sand. So when you start panning, you're like the best panner in Alaska. You know, just stud panner, all the guys that do all the tapping and shifting and been doing it. Warm gold pan in their hand. And yet now, you know, some desk jockey like me, take all that black sand out of the mix. Damn, just as fast. But perhaps, in my opinion, more accuracy. Why? Because the process of shifting all the material through those black sands has been eliminated. It takes so much time and has so much losses. This time about twice as much as I normally would have it because I pulled it out really quick. I didn't let it kind of just sit there. I just wanted to see, you know, how much material it was holding. Just, you know, while you're running it, you know, it's always just changing up a little bit, see what's going on. Going super fast, I've got my safety pan. Nice, this got really good, you know, solid, repeatable motions. Does a good job. Frank actually puts little notches in the bottom of his pan. That's this guy's. And it acts like a little rattle table. You know, it goes back and forth. And he says it settles the black sands out there. I mean, the gold. I don't do that. Just because I haven't had time to do it yet. Lazy. He likes it. He does a lot of panning though. He goes through a lot of material. He does a lot of testing for folks. He does a lot of them. Does a lot of testing for folks. Tests the material, freshens it up. Camera now. Do the one-handed jockey so you guys could all make fun of me. Ooh, my wrist is just totally trashed from digging. Yeah, I'm a wuss. What can I say? Oh. Now let's look at it. Get rid of some water. Got some gold trying to slip down. There, I should be able to get pseudo it all in one spot now. One more little bitty time. There it is. Yeah, just wouldn't reset. There it is. So there's the gold. That's in the first shake. I'll show you the second shake, and then I gotta blow to go to a concert and relax with the wife. Well, there it is. A couple little specks I missed. I'm sure there's more in there. I'll pan through them and do a final shot of the total when I get home, maybe tomorrow. Pack my crap up the hill. There's my wimpy reclaimed job with my rake, Japanese sand style, and I'm out of here. Ah, such a gorgeous spot. God, I love Montana.